Hey. Hey. Welcome to the show. Live from Dennis's house. The only show of its kind in the entire world. Every Sunday morning, 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, my YouTube channel, Live from Dennis's house. It's a lot of fun, and today we're going to be doing Motley Crue, and my special guest is Sharon Bestine.
Hi.
We're going to be doing Dr. Feelgood by Motley Crue. Hold that up a little bit more. There you go.
Nice.
So I want to tell a little story of how Sharon happened to fill in. First, I want to tell a story how how I came to play pick the Motley Crue for this week. All right, so it all started back in the days when I was in this band, the Primitive Dogs, back in the 90s. We were the greatest cover band of all time, by the way. I just wanted you to know.
I've heard that from you.
Yes, I say that a lot.
Yes.
But anyway, we had these two groupies, if you will, Fran and Cindy, who would come to our shows all the time. They had really long blonde hair, and they would stand right in front of the stage and just shake their heads like the headbangers, waving their hair crazy. And, you know, we got to know them over the time, and they were equally crazy, right? So I haven't spoken to him, I guess, in good 15 years or so, but through the beauty of Facebook, we reconnected recently. So I said, oh, you guys want to come on the show? You're pretty insane. I think you'll be good guests. So we're going back and forth for the longest time, and they're all nervous and stuff. And then they said, all right, they want to do Whitesnake first. And I said, I definitely don't have Whitesnake albums.
You would need a car in here.
See, that would have been good. Yeah, you could have been on the hood.
On the hood.
So I didn't have any Whitesnake, so we settled on Motley Crue, and my friend Doug had a Motley Crue album. So hold that one up, the first one.
I'm not so good at this.
That's the first album that I borrowed from my friend Doug. So put it down now. And I was listening to that, and it wasn't that great. So I was like, I don't like anything off of this album. It's going to be terrible. So, you know, not being a fan of this genre really at all, I was
This is not you. I was happy that you said Motley Crue, because it's so me.
That's what it worked out perfectly. 80s. So anyway, Fran and Cindy were supposed to come on, but then last night, I didn't like that album, so I went out and I went to the record store and I actually bought a brand new copy of Dr. Feelgood, because it has a lot of good songs
on
it.
Very good choice.
Yes, so
I also like Girls, 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 though.
Yeah.
Good album.
So they got better, actually, with each album. Got a little bit better, I think.
I agree.
So anyway, Fran and Cindy said, last night they texted me and said, oh no, that Fran actually married some guy named Fran. They were both Fran and Fran, and then something happened to him, so they're all distraught and they can't come to the show.
So here I am, back up.
Yes. I always wanted you, though.
It's
not
know.
Like I said, I always wanted you on the show.
Let's be clear. Let's clear that up.
And Sharon is, oh, I have to mention that you're married to Mike Bestine.
Oh, we need to mention that.
Carol Ann makes me, all the female guests that come on, I always have to say that they're married, so people don't think anything
yes.
is weird. So,
anyway. Well, we are weird.
Yes, that goes without saying. So, we're all dressed in our Motley Crue gear today. I have my little neckerchief on, and Sharon has our 80s headband on.
Vince Neil headband going.
Yep, so, and we got Dr. Feelgood blaring in
my
the background.
My favorite
down
song.
There. Is your favorite song of this?
Of course, it doesn't want to feel good.
Yes, absolutely.
Right, you know, Dr. Feelgood.
And Girls, 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 Girls is a good song, too. They
Kickstart Your Heart?
Yeah, yeah. Do you know why that song, why he wrote that song?
Which one, Kickstart Your Heart?
Yeah.
Nope.
Nikki Sixx wrote that because he OD'd. And he was clinically dead for 2 minutes, and on the way to the hospital, the guy driving the ambulance was a big Motley Crue fan, so he gave him 2 shots of the adrenaline thing, extra one. Normally, they'll give it one, and then you're dead, and they'll say, screw you.
But this guy, Nikki Sixx.
Yeah, so it was Nikki Sixx. This guy was a Motley Crue fan, so he gave him extra, so he got his heart kickstarted.
Kickstart
my heart.
See? I like that song a lot.
See,
and a little go
ahead.
To feel good, Home Sweet Home.
Yes. Oh, and not to mention, that's what later on, me and my friend Alan are going to be performing Home Sweet Home. So that should be a good treat. And
nice.
Sharon is going to show off her musical skills as well.
Oh,
well,
really?
She'll be playing the piano.
Oh,
and yes, that's going
to
be.
As long as I have to sing.
No, no singing. Thank you. just playing a piano. And that's so it should
it's
be
very
a good
elementary
show.
Piano skills. Let's not get crazy.
So but it's gonna be good though. It's gonna
good
be a
show.
Good show. So I gotta say it, I was not really a fan of theirs back in the '80s. I was more of a punk fan, but out of all those bands from the '80s, I really think they definitely are the best. But like when you have Poison, Winger, and all those bands from the '80s, I like
Striper. The Poser Christian Rock. Let's not forget them.
Yeah. So but
was Motley Crue, were they considered posers? Were they a poser?
No, I think
or rock.
They were rock, yeah. And, you know, that, like I said, after the first album, it got progressively better. And Girls, Girls, Girls is the quintessential stripper song that every stripper in the world back in the day probably still does.
I played it in my spin class. No one strips.
Oh, do you? So, yeah, so let's talk about that. You are a fitness guru and a instructor of some sort.
I teach a spin class. I play a lot of Motley Crue. Good for sprints.
You want to say where you give your spin class?
Vive Fitness in Point Pleasant Beach.
Oh, okay.
It's a good time. Yeah. We're almost full, so.
What happens at
gotta
spin?
Gotta get there soon.
What do you do at spin?
Ride a bike.
Oh, really?
Yes.
And that's why they call it spinning?
Yes. It has a weighted wheel.
Oh, okay.
So you're on the bike for an hour.
Wow, an hour?
An hour. That's why I haven't seen you.
Yeah, definitely not gonna see me either.
Or Carolyn. She hasn't shown up either.
Isn't it just for girls, though? Do boys do this, too?
No. Boys like it.
Oh, okay. Then maybe I will show up.
Because you play good music.
All right, yeah. I'll just come for the Motley Crue now that I'm a big fan.
I will make a special playlist just for you, Dennis.
This is part of my growing up and maturing. I'm letting go of all my hang-ups, and this is one of them, that I didn't like Motley Crue and all that hair bands, but I actually went out and bought this album. I'm listening to it now. I'm actually liking
$18.
It. $18. $18 I paid for this brand new album. I never paid that
in a
day.
You can get it on iTunes.
Nah, it's not the
like
same.
Like $8.
It's not the same.
The whole album. Greatest hits.
No way. You can get all their albums.
Actually, free music. You don't have to pay for it.
I went because I tried to find it in the used bin, but there was none in the used bin. So
you didn't inherit this from my dad's collection?
I wish.
You didn't have this?
I didn't get your dad's collection.
You didn't get
albums.
His albums?
No.
What happened to them?
I don't know. I wish I
really
got them, yeah.
I thought they
maybe
came right
your
across
mom
the street.
Still has them. Yeah, so that's how me and Sharon know each other, that her mom lives right across the street from me, and we met as soon as we moved in, and we have kids the same age, and we've spent
Christmas Eve together for the past, 12, 13 years?
At least.
All day and night.
Yes, we have a party here, and then we have a party over there, but her mom's since moved, but it's only 5 seconds away, so.
And New Year's Eve, we've spent together.
I don't recall that.
Well, you were invited somewhere else and they canceled. Remember?
No.
You don't remember? It's someone who always cancels.
Okay.
And we had a bet.
Yes.
So you guys came to my house.
Oh, that's right. And I can say this. Her initials are Danielle Mulhern, right?
Yes. Tag her in this video. Hi, Danielle.
She doesn't usually watch. I'll know whether she watches or not.
She is my Facebook friend.
Oh, okay. So I'm going to definitely
tell you.
I'll know if she watches. Yeah. Well, I'll explain it now. That we were friends with Danielle, and she used to have parties like all the time, but she would always cancel at the last minute.
And here I am again, backup. Yes. I am just always the backup for the Murcillo.
So if you could do good today, you're going to be my semi-permanent host.
Woo-hoo!
Whenever anyone backs out, I'll put you on the list.
Oh, thank you.
Especially if it's like Motley Crue or heavy metal stuff.
Guns N' Roses, I like them.
Can't wait to do Guns N' Roses.
I have a Guns N' Roses story.
Oh, nice. Don't tell that now. Save that for the Guns N' Roses show. So,
It's a concert show. It was fun. I can't tell it?
No, we'll save it when we do the Guns N' Roses show.
What if I'm not here?
You'll be here. I'll make sure of that. I'll put it on my list. So, do you have a Motley Crue story? Or?
No, I never went to their concert.
Oh, okay.
Although they are playing at PNC. Maybe
yes.
We should
go.
Yes,
you
want
to go? Yes,
we
all right,
go.
That's it, we're there. They might be sold out already. Yeah, that's great.
Oh, we'll have connection. Like we'll get some. We know someone who's a Live Nation person.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How long do you think you keep that from me? Now you'd be my sidekick at
it's
all.
It's really
all
not
the
a friend.
Time.
It's Mike's connection.
That's fine.
And he doesn't like to abuse it.
Oh.
Not like us.
Yeah, I would abuse that for sure.
Exactly.
You're going to end up not being friends with him eventually, so you might as well just abuse it while you can.
Yeah, Mike met...
I hope this guy's not
one of the Chili Peppers.
What? What about the Chili Peppers?
Mike met one of the guys from the Chili Peppers.
Oh, my God. Mike's going to be my new sidekick as well. Get him on the show.
Oh, he likes Journey.
Oh, that would be good.
Huey Lewis. Oh, God. You don't want him.
The best joke ever was Sam Kinison back when he was still alive, and Huey Lewis had that song out, It's Hip to Be Square.
Yeah.
And Sam Kinison was making fun of it. Hip to be square. Where's it hip to be square? It must be the same place where it's hip to be called Huey. thought that was very fun.
is a legend out there about Huey Lewis.
Really? What?
You have to Google that.
Oh, I'm going to look that up. Mm-hmm. You don't want to share that
with us? No, I don't want to share that.
Oh, all right. Did you have any 80s stories here? Well,
you won't let me tell it.
But not, all right, go ahead.
It was a Deep Purple, Aerosmith, Guns N' Roses concert.
Really?
Giant stadium. Me and my girlfriends, maybe 15, 16. Why we were at that concert alone, I don't know, but we were. And we had first tier seating.
All right.
We hopped the wall down to the floor.
Oh, snap.
In skirts.
Wow.
And then we had to run from the security guards. They were chasing us through Giant Stadium. We're like, that's my story.
Did you get away?
And then we wound up on shoulders with some guys, on the floor. Yeah.
I think I saw you in the Girls, Girls, Girls video,
that
actually.
Could have been me. Could have been us.
And speaking of the Aerosmith, that they were friends, I guess. But did you know that they wrote the song "Dude Looks Like a Lady" for Vince Neil?
They did.
Yes, that his picture was up on the ballroom wall or on the door, or whatever. And Steven Tyler was walking in.
He's got nerve.
Yeah,
because he kind of looks like a girl.
Nah, he looks much cooler than that.
Steven Tyler?
Yeah, he doesn't look like a girl at all.
All right.
But that's where the lyrics, his picture greased the grime on the door.
Girly.
Yeah. See, that's what I was going to talk to Fran and Cindy about, because they love this heavy metal stuff and they love boys that look like girls. And I was going to say to them,
no, I don't like that.
Don't you think it's kind of odd that you like girls? I mean, it's odd that you like boys that look like girls.
And she married somebody named Fran.
Exactly. Because wouldn't it be weird if I liked girls that look like boys?
Yeah, maybe. It depends what you're into.
That's the new me. I don't judge anybody. I accept all. This show is about love and accepting people and
it's so
all
much
that
easier.
Stuff. Yeah, right?
Like,
yeah.
No negativity.
It's exhausting.
I hate it.
Hating people. I hated people all my life, but now I've gotten
You
over
were a little
that.
Bitter.
Yeah, right? I was a bitter, angry person.
You were.
Now I just like
Never to
joke.
Me. We always clicked.
Yeah, we always got along very well.
Very well.
But everybody else I hated.
Well, so, you do live in this snotty little neighborhood, so.
Hey, stop saying that. Yeah, we have a battle of neighborhoods between our neighborhood and Sharon's
Ocean County. Monmouth County.
So why? What do you say about
now
our neighborhood?
Now you come OTB and think you're cool. I show up. I was at a Christmas party, and out of the blue, we're just hanging out, and who walks in but Dennis?
Yes, that's right. My band was playing
at this party.
His band was
playing at a Christmas party. What are the odds of that?
You didn't even know.
I had no idea.
Be there, and it worked out good.
It did work out.
You were saying you have a story about that Christmas party that something happened.
I do have a story. I am having surgery on Thursday. I've had glass in my elbow since that party. It was December.
That was the Christmas party. Yeah.
15th. I was while you were in there entertaining the guests.
Right.
Apparently, I was entertaining the kitchen. I was introducing someone. Oh, hi, this is so-and-so. When I came back, my elbow shattered a wine glass in someone's hand.
Wow. That's from all that spinning. You're so
massive
powerful.
Strength,
yeah, right?
Here. Yes. And I've had glass in my elbow ever since.
Why didn't you just take it out when it happened?
I kind of felt it, but I couldn't find it.
Oh, it went deep into your skin?
You could feel it now. Feel it. It's in my muscle.
Ooh, I don't feel anything, but...
it's hard. You
did
can
it,
feel it.
Like, you must have been bleeding a lot then.
It was a tiny little slit.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the wine glass got the worst of it.
And you did. What about the person's hand who was holding it? Did that?
No, she just kept holding the top of the glass shattered. She was still holding it and was contemplating drinking her wine.
Oh, God.
She's like, I don't know. Do I drink it? Do I not? And then later on, someone went to get an olive, and there was a big hunk of glass in the olive dish.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
So what were you
wait until Ventrini gets my lawyer bill.
Oh,
I can guarantee
right.
you that gig pretty much every year. Dennis will be at the Ventrini Christmas
party. Say, I want my medical bills paid. I want this.
That
might have
been
Dennis
my house.
The
they
band.
Did just put
yeah.
in a nice pool.
Yeah, there you go. So
it was a nice house.
Yeah, it was very nice.
Yeah,
it was a very nice party. And So didn't you try and take it out with a scalpel by yourself at one point?
I did. Well,
joking?
I couldn't find the scalpel, so I used the pin.
Oh, yeah,
and I was
there you
picking
go.
And picking.
Ugh,
and I went to a dermatologist, and she said it was a cyst, but she didn't wind up removing something from my back. I'm like, I'm not
well,
here for
here.
That. So, <I don't... laughs> so yeah, that I got something scraped off my back. She didn't touch my elbow. So then I followed up with an orthopedic.
Yeah.
Thursday.
Wow, that's something.
Yeah, local anesthetic and everything.
Oh my goodness.
Yes, I can't wait to see how
painful.
Big it is.
Yeah, right?
I want that glass.
Save that piece of glass,
I want
yes.
It.
We'll bring that back on the next show.
We'll bring it back.
Definitely.
And it's my right elbow, thank God, because I am lefty.
Yes. So I got to check my notes here about what else I wanted to talk about here. because I got a lot of news stories to talk about. Oh, and these band members. Oh,
they're bad news, right?
They got a lot. That's what another reason I like this. They were so interesting. They lived life. They were...
like the ladies.
Crazy, yes. They love drinking and drugs and strippers and everything that rock stars are supposed to like. Mm-hmm. And they had a lot of fun out there in L.A. and the Sunset Strip and all this stuff.
Did you ever see the Tommy Lee Pamela Anderson video?
Oh, yes.
I did as well.
It's very good.
It's impressive.
Should we give a review of this?
It was impressive.
I thought it was a good movie, but the cinematography left a lot to be desired. And I don't know about the key grip either. Take that more than one way. But anyway, yeah. They were all married like 4 times. They all got tattoos. So they seem like cool guys.
There's nothing wrong with tattoos,
yeah,
really.
Yeah, I know. That's what I like about it. I think
I'll
have
fun.
Yeah,
you're all linked up.
Oh, that's the
maybe
thing.
Maybe I'll get a tattoo.
That's what you should. Maybe after the show,
maybe
we'll go
I
and
will.
Get tattoos.
All
or right. When we go see Motley Crue, we'll go get tattoos afterwards.
Right. I love Vince.
And I'll get I love Nikki. Because, I got a tattoo actually the same place they got their tattoos. We were in California one time and we're on the Sunset Strip, and I said, I'm going to get a tattoo at Sunset Strip Tattoos. And I really did. One of my first tattoos.
Closest thing I got was a belly ring at Slinging Ink. So it wasn't a tattoo parlor.
There you go.
I had it for like 2 weeks. So, but I still have the ring.
Nice.
Gonna wear it to belly collapse.
Yeah, so, they all live crazy life that, like, Nikki Sixx, he wrote that book. I couldn't find it, but I read that book, and I still have it. It's called The Heroin Diaries. He was a big drug addict, as I said. He OD'd and was dead for 2 minutes, but he lived a crazy life, and this book was really good, talking all about it. And did you know that he dated Vanity? You remember Vanity? Prince's protege, that girl?
No.
Yeah, well, he did. Apparently, he dated her, and, very interesting.
Vince Neil killed someone.
Exactly, yes.
His friend,
the guy from
Razzle,
yes, that was it, from I think Hanoi Rocks,
yes.
Was the band. And they were driving drunk
on a beer run,
yes. And he had this like fancy car, I forget what it was. It was like $1 million car, and he got a head-on collision and killed this guy. The people in the other car were injured so bad that they had brain damage and all this stuff. Nothing happened to Vince Neil at all.
He had 200 hours of community service and I think 30 days of jail time.
Yes, but I was reading it. It was 30 days, but he only spent 18 days in jail.
That's it?
That's it.
This had to be years ago before drinking and driving was a big deal.
But he did get a $2 million fine, which was very excessive. But
not to him.
Yeah, no. So, you know, money can get you out of anything. What do you think if I killed all those people in a car crash? I'd still be in jail.
You would not be sitting here right now rocking this show.
Doing my show from cell block number 9. Right now.
Yeah.
So there you go. So
you might not be sitting so straight.
Exactly. No, I'd be running my cell block. I'm convinced of that. I think I would do okay in jail.
Yeah?
If not, I think my humor would win people over in jail. I think I'd go along.
You think you'd be okay with that?
Yeah, not with that. That wouldn't be taking place. I'd be perfectly fine.
I don't know.
Yes.
I've heard some stories.
Yeah, well... wouldn't it be me?
So, all right,
do you
go with that.
Do you want to go into this topic now? That I've always thought about that. That what happens to guys when they're perfectly straight out here, and then they go into jail and they feel the need to partake in that? I don't understand.
I don't know if they feel a need.
Well, obviously, but you know, why would you do that? I don't understand.
I don't know.
Well, that's
I don't
another
think they,
show.
I really don't think they have a choice. I think
no, I'm talking about the guys.
Do you want a spoon to eat dinner? Do you want to eat dinner?
No, the guys who are perpetrating this act on the other guys. That's what I'm saying about.
They were bullies in school, maybe.
Exactly, but still, that's a little extreme, don't you think?
How long have they been in there? I don't know.
I'm pretty confident that if I was in jail for life,
that's when you start playing Dr.
Okay.
Feelgood.
All right, this is a family show. We got to get off this topic now. So,
you went there, not me.
All right, so let's play a little more. They got a lot of great songs on here. And all their songs about, like
I
you
love
said,
the mugs, by the way.
Oh, yeah, want to hold up on mugs? Live from Dennis's house.
Love it. Do I get to keep this?
No way.
It's not a souvenir. Oh, well, maybe if Fran showed up, she would have got it.
Yeah, they'd get one across the skull if they show up now. And then they said, oh, can we do it next week? And I said, no, I'm booked up through the summer. You're dead to me. See,
and
that's my
that
goose love.
That is true. That is Dennis. There's no second chances with Dennis. Threw me right off the volleyball team. That was it.
Oh, yeah, let's talk a little bit about a volleyball team.
No, I'm done.
We have a beach volleyball team that we've been playing for many years. And we are the Denver Broncos of beach volleyball.
The Buffalo Bills.
Yeah, whoever it is. that every year we go undefeated, we crush the other teams, we never even go to a third game in the series.
And then we play that glove team with those.
Exactly.
Gloves.
And then we get to the
gloves.
And we go through the playoffs,
it's all
no
that
problem.
Intimidation.
And then we get to the Super Bowl of beach volleyball and we lose every single
year.
And I end up storming off in tears because I'm a very sore loser.
You really are.
And I just storm off and I don't speak to anyone for the rest of the year on the team. So.
And then I'll shoot out an email soon. It should be coming. The text.
I'm thinking,
the email.
Well, see this.
Maybe I'm going to come out of retirement.
Maybe, yeah. I got to see. I'm still, because we got to sign up soon if we're going to do it. So I got to decide if I'm going to do it again. I don't know if I can go through that heartbreak again. But I'll see. So.
I think it's that lady wears those gloves.
Yeah, it's the same woman every year.
They're scary.
Yeah.
And then that one guy brings the rookies in.
Yeah, that's the problem. The other team
a teacher in our school.
They bring like professional volleyball players in for the Super Bowl.
Yeah,
and we don't.
That's not fair. So. We should need to start checking the roster.
And we're nice.
And
we let everybody play and all that stuff. So yeah, Sharon
was on
the team.
And then how about our teammate who just shows up for the playoffs who sucks?
You can't say that. She's going to be listening.
I don't know.
We're alienating everybody. That's it. This forget peace, love, and understanding.
I say it how it is, Dennis. If people don't like it.
That's it. That's good.
I don't care. It is what it is.
Yeah, so we'll have to see about beach volleyball this year. We'll have to decide soon.
But, she got action from the team, too.
Yeah, I threw Caroline off the team. You know, that's it. She stinks. And
I didn't stink. I'm not sure
no,
why
you
I got
threw yourself off, didn't you?
Maybe I did. Yeah, I think it was a marital thing.
Yeah, it's hard to be on a team with your spouse on a volleyball team. Yeah.
He had way too much to say. But that's every day. All right, we won't go there either.
All right, so what else? Let's talk about all the members of the band.
Okay.
We went through Vince Neil, killed somebody, married four times. Tommy Lee, we know about Pamela Anderson. And, Heather Locklear.
Heather
he was
Locklear.
With her, too. She
yeah.
was something. Did you used to watch Melrose Place?
I did.
Me, too. Who was your favorite?
I like Jake.
I like Sydney, the girl with the
red
hair.
Oh, the red hair?
Yeah.
She was cute. No, Jake.
Yeah, and then who's the other guys in the band? Mickey Mars is the guitar player who we didn't talk about, but he has some debilitating rare disease that he's had it, and it's
and he's still gonna be a PNC.
He gets through it, but it's like some form of arthritis, and it affects his spine, his whole body, and it like compresses him down and hunches him over, and that he's actually 6 inches shorter now than he was in high school.
Really?
Yes.
That's an interesting story.
Yeah. But that's why he has to...
I hope he was taller.
That's why they're retiring. By about 5 years, he'll completely disappear. And
is this their last show?
Yeah, this is the farewell tour. This.
Oh, I should have bought that shirt. Again. There was a shirt on Facebook that said, "This girl loves Motley Crue."
Oh, yeah. See,
my girlfriend wanted it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even think we're going to the concert.
I think we are.
We have to talk to that Live Nation guy.
Yeah, definitely. So we'll look into that. And then...
And who else was there? There's been, 7 or 8 members? Because two
left. I'm not talking about any of those guys because...
the ones that don't count? But
yeah,
isn't there
more
that
count.
Counts? There's more than...
I named four of them, didn't I?
Four?
That, Tommy Lee, Nikki Six.
All right.
Nikki
Tommy
Six.
Tommy Lee's badass.
Yeah.
He's
and
bad boy.
Yeah, he was, like we said, with... Pamela Anderson, and he got into a fight like at the Grammys.
He's not a good looking guy, and he gets these pretty girls, right?
He's a millionaire.
Well, so are they,
know?
Though.
And drugs. A lot of drugs involved,
of drugs.
Too. Yeah, so.
Yeah. We know what it is. We saw the video. That's what it was.
The family show. Settle down. I keep telling you that.
Well, we didn't say what it was. If they saw the video, they know.
So. Let's name all these songs on here. A lot of songs. Dr. FeelGood, about drugs. Slice of Your Pie. I think we know where they're going with that. Rattlesnake Shake, probably about the same thing. Kickstart My Heart, Without You. Same Old Situation, that's a good song. I want to, we'll move this down to... Wow, listen to that nice ballad that the ladies love. Yeah, so, and then we'll turn it over, so... And the other song, She Goes Down. I wonder what that's about.
I don't know.
Yeah. A lot of cryptic songs here. I have no idea. Maybe we'll read the lyrics, figure out what it's about. But anyway, I think it's time we start doing some news stories here.
All right.
And let's see. What is my first news story? Oh, this... actually, I'm going to put my glasses on for this.
Oh, Jesus.
So I can read.
See, I just turned 40. I don't need them yet.
Oh, I got to get serious for a minute here.
Okay.
I've never done this on a show before, but a friend requested... that I make sure everyone knows that April 2nd is Wear Blue for Autism Day.
Oh, okay.
So
That's a good cause.
Yes.
I have something going on April 2nd. I'm sure
whatever you're doing, you can wear blue while you're doing it.
I think I can.
Yes.
April 2nd.
So this first story, it reminds me of you, which about your Friday nights. But anyway, yeah. This guy, on Friday, March 21st, he was arrested in Florida. A lot of nonsense goes on in Florida. Did you notice
really?
That?
Really? A lot of drugs in Florida.
Every story I read is people acting crazy in Florida. So anyway, this guy...
Sun is frying their brains. That's why.
Yeah. So he was arrested in Daytona police. He walked into a bar, ordered and downed $80 worth of shots, set fire to a trash can in the bathroom, and punched several people in the face.
I wasn't in Florida that weekend.
Yes. So, it was including a man over 70, too. So this guy, he did 10 shots of Jägermeister, and then he set the fire, and he tried to escape without paying, and these guys tried to stop him. So he punched one guy in the face, another guy tried to help him, and he punched him in the face. And, you got to hear what he's charged with. That's the best part. He's charged with arson, criminal mischief, aggravated battery, defrauding an innkeeper of under $300. Now, that law has to be from, like, 1658, you know, defrauding an innkeeper. What is that? There's no way that's a legitimate...
For $300.
Yes, that must have been, like, a million back then. And then another one, battery on an elderly person more than 65 years old.
That's not nice.
Yeah, I didn't know there's a special law just for that.
For age.
Like, yeah, if you...
It's discrimination.
If you punch a 60-year-old in the face...
It's okay.
It's okay. But if 65, then you're in big
then
trouble.
Then you're in trouble.
Or 70, yeah.
So, that sounds like discrimination to me. Yes. I think they can get off on that.
So this guy's in big trouble here, and he's out on bail now. And, I know what else. Did you hear in, let's turn this over now. That in South, it's probably North Korea, yeah.
Hey, to flip the record.
I don't do politics, but this is a good story.
Yeah, I don't really either.
I'm against politics. But anyway, North Korea,
like so much.
Kim Jong-un, he decreed... Oh, this is a good song, too. But this is a good stripper song as well. So I hear.
I'm not stripping for you tonight.
The family show.
I didn't go to that class. I didn't take belly or hip-hop. I never showed up.
Kim Jong-un decreed in North Korea that everyone has to have the same haircut as him. Did you hear about this?
No.
See? Yes, he absolutely did. I'm not joking. And so they posted pictures of what people would look like, with that haircut. So... He's one of our president with that haircut.
Yeah, I don't see it political. I'm not a big fan of his.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of anyone. Except you and Motley Crue.
You love everyone, you just said.
Not anymore.
I forgot the best in you.
Here's what, Obama would look like with that haircut. So I'm thinking
That's
of getting
kind of
that, too.
Yeah,
it does actually look good.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking of getting that. That would be so funny, I think, for next show if I have that haircut.
I don't want to get it,
And then I see on Facebook a lot, everyone's posting those pictures of the before and after of crystal meth.
Oh, that's some scary shit.
Yeah, look at this.
That's why I never did that.
So look at this. Before and after of crystal meth. Look at these people.
That's scary.
It's ridiculous. Who's going to be doing crystal meth?
News.
Yes, kids out there.
No
look
drugs.
At these pictures and you tell me this is something that you think would be reasonable. Look at that. Look how beautiful these girls
were
before.
Look at her. Oh, my goodness.
And look at what they end up like.
True story right there,
yeah.
Kids.
Just say no.
This is what no drugs looks like right here.
Exactly.
Us.
Before and after. See? It's not much different than this, really. Look at this.
Oh, my God. That is scary.
That's
that
actually...
That looks like the zombie walk.
That is a zombie.
Yeah, I think
But it's the same thing as before and after of meth. You really
I thought
think someone looked like that?
Yeah.
So, that was that. You got anything else you want to talk about? Sharon, any stories before I get to all these other news stories and Motley Crue stuff?
I do
stuff.
Like your velvet.
Yes, of course.
Am I allowed to touch it?
Of course.
All right. Some days
thinking,
I'm not. Some
I'm
days
thinking,
you're a little cranky about
I'm
it.
I'm thinking I might need to either insure this. No, I don't wear it on the show. This is the red one I wear all the time. So I might need to insure this jacket or get another one because I wear it a lot now, so it's going to
start
wearing out.
I'm going to start checking the consignment
out.
Shops for you.
Yeah, yeah. So see, and it can't
if
be.
If I went in them.
It can't be a phony costume one either.
I'm
that looks cheesy.
Shops. Can we get these new?
No. Well, you can, but it, I think, because
right.
I got this at a consignment.
You
and
did?
It's official. It's a 1956 one. So, let me read some more stories then. Let's see. Oh, the tiger that attacked Siegfried and Roy passed away.
Oh, he did?
Yes.
I stayed at Treasure Island when I was in Vegas. I saw that.
Oh, really? You saw the Siegfried and Roy show?
I did.
Which was your favorite, Siegfried or Roy?
I didn't like the whole thing.
They were a little weird, I have to say. So what else? This woman, this is a good story. It happened in Florida as well. Carolyn Winan, 56, right? She, the police called her and said, there's a party going on at your house with your underage teenagers, and do you give permission to clear everybody out of the house and stop this party? And she goes, yes, of course, officer, go ahead. So as the cops are clearing the house, they find the mom hiding in the closet because she allowed the party and she gave everybody booze and everything. And
there's
so,
a lot of parents like that.
Yeah, well,
not
it
here.
Ain't me.
Not here. If they're gonna do it, they're gonna sneak it in.
Yeah,
we're
right?
Not gonna supply
no way.
It. Kids today are just—they can't get away with anything.
Oh, so here's a story that didn't happen in Florida. It actually happened in Toms River. That this guy, he robbed the Stride Right shoe store in Toms
For
River.
What?
For money and shoes.
Oh,
they were rare platforms that he wanted back in the day. But this was 15 years ago. He robbed the Stride Right.
Aren't they baby shoes? What's he going to do with them? Maybe he has that same disease as Mickey Mars. He's shrinking.
Yes. So he's probably shrinking, so he needs his baby shoes.
Baby shoes for the platform. So, yes, he's taller.
Yeah. So yeah, and one leg is shorter than the other, so he needs
he's
a big...
Oh, he's got all kinds of issues.
Yeah, he's got...
Maybe so. I could send him to my orthopedic, too.
So this guy, he robbed the Stride Right 15 years ago. He went to jail. He's sentenced to 15 years because for robbing... There's a little other known law that robbing a shoe innkeeper of shoes is a crime as
this
well.
This is the New Jersey law.
Yes.
I should have become a lawyer. We need to know all these little laws.
And it's robbing an innkeeper, a shoekeeper with wooden teeth of less than $500. So he sent to jail for 15 years, and he gets out, and
he goes right back.
Right. He was in jail in Atlantic City.
God.
He took a bus back to Toms River. Got off, robbed the same shoe store again, made the people go in the back room and stuff, and when they refused, he got agitated.
Was anyone there?
There was,
like,
a,
was it the same manager, maybe?
No, I don't think so. I think he's been moved up now. Yeah, yeah.
Stride
to
right.
The district manager now he is.
That's
so anyway,
creepy, though.
Yeah, he got arrested, and the cops is saying, like, well, apparently he enjoyed it in jail. So, see, I'm telling you, jail's not that bad. It doesn't.
Well,
you know?
It's kind of like the Shawshank Redemption. They keep going back, right? They do stuff afterwards,
exactly,
and they want to,
yeah.
Or they're institutionalized. They
exactly.
Don't know how to survive.
So, yeah, he was young when he went in. Spent
great
15
movie,
years
by the way.
In there. Yes, very good. Which is better, Shawshank or Tommy Lee movie?
That's a tough one. Depends what kind of mood I'm in.
So, all right, so. That's see how many moons. It's been a busy week. That so much stuff went on.
Yeah, I kind of stopped reading the newspaper, local news. There's never anything positive.
Yeah, see, that's
and
good.
It helps me stay positive.
Right, and you don't need to read. Nobody needs to read anymore. You just need to watch my show, and I'll tell you all the interesting news.
Well,
and you weed out all that nonsense. You know.
I'm gonna have to start watching it more
yes.
often. Sometimes
and,
I see 35 minutes. I'm like, shush.
Yeah, you've got nothing better to do. Stop that. Get home
I'm
from your
busy.
Spin class. Sunday morning,
that's
you're not doing anything. What are you doing on Sunday morning that you're too busy to do this?
Sunday morning.
Exactly.
Oh, a dance competition
There's
tomorrow.
There's no dance competition.
Absolutely.
What do you mean dance? What do you? Who's dancing in
Me
a competition?
Me and my friend have a competition tomorrow at 8 a.m.
I got to hear about this. Go ahead.
She thinks she's better than me and everything, and I continue to show her up. As in bowling. We bowled last night.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
How'd
I
that
won.
Go? Oh, really?
It was like, it came right back to me. My foot was sliding sideways behind me by the end of the night and everything.
So,
I was in the league when I was young.
Yeah, I know. I heard about this. Your bowling expertise.
No.
What?
My mother's been bowling for how many years?
Yeah.
She still is awful.
You can still beat her, even though she bowls every week?
About two leagues a week. And no, I don't think she ever broke 100.
Wow.
Yeah. Sounds... No, I was like 8 or 9 Saturday morning league.
Oh, okay.
What else is there to do in Island?
That's true. That way you grew up, Island, New Jersey?
Or I would look like this.
Yeah, right?
You know, it's either bowl or that.
Yes, bowling is a wholesome sport.
It
keeps
kept
people
me
out of trouble.
Trouble.
Whatever, anything that keeps people out of trouble is all for. So, what else do we have here? Oh, there's so much I gotta get through all this. I gotta report on the deaths. The lead singer of the band Guar passed away. You ever hear of Guar?
I have never heard of that.
Fran and Cindy would have known them for sure. They're a really heavy metal band. And
I wasn't a real metalhead.
Yeah. James Rebhorn died. He's a famous actor. I know him best from Meet the Parents. He played Dr. Bob in Meet the Parents. That was one of my favorite movies.
And Dr. Bob died?
Yeah. From Meet the Parents.
Yeah, I did. Yeah. I love that movie.
Yes, that was my favorite. David Cassidy was sent to rehab for his third DWI. So
really?
How do you think David Cassidy's going to do in prison?
Yeah. He's a pretty boy.
Yes, absolutely.
He's going to be popular.
Back in the day, I must say, David Cassidy, I might have had a man crush on David Cassidy, that if I was in prison, I might like David Cassidy, I would say.
He had great hair.
Yeah, definitely. Maybe I'll turn my hairstyle into either Kim Jong-un or David Cassidy circa 1970.
There's a remake of their song from the Partridge Family out there. Yeah, it's called,
is there really?
It's called Let's Get Nasty, but it's the same beat. He's going to be singing that in prison.
Wow, I didn't know that.
I'll play it for you later.
So, all right. And now, another story that I found interesting. Steven Seagal is now helping Vladimir Putin in Russia get the Russian citizens into shape.
So, really? Does he have the ponytail?
He has the ponytail. His
but
hair
he's
is
so bald,
his
right?
His hair is jet black. No, it's like he shoe polished his hair. And he's huge now. He's not in shape at all. That this is the best
but
person they can
find. But he was balding in the 80s. He cannot have...
No, he's got more
gotta
hair.
He's got to just have the ponytail.
No,
like
he's
tail.
Got more hair. He's got a full head. It looked like...
Then he must have implants.
I wish
I
had this picture because it looked like he went to the Party City and got one of those samurai wigs and put it on, you know?
I'll have to look that
exactly.
up.
Exactly. You gotta look that up. It's funny. So... Oh, this
I
is
did
a,
like his movies back
yeah,
in the day.
Yeah, those were good.
They were.
I gotta get to all this. We're running all out right. of time. There was so much. A bridge player died after getting a perfect hand at bridge. This 80-year-old bridge player in England died at the table shortly after winning a game with a 1 in 150,000 chance hand of cards. Wendy Brown, 80, who was Cornwall's highest-ranked player, had just scored 29 points in the game when she collapsed.
It was so perfect she had a heart attack.
Yes. So her son Charlie, who said a blood vessel near her heart had failed, said other players had responded magnificently and tried to revive her when she collapsed. But paramedics were called, but it is thought she was dead when
they
arrived.
Well, they obviously didn't kickstart her heart.
Exactly. And, you know, they're so nice in England, you know, over here. Because look what he says. He says, when all is said and done, it was a lovely way. Oh, I'll do my British accent.
Oh, I have one of those, too.
When all is said and done. Oh, I don't know what kind of accent that was. But unless I say governor, I can't get a British accent going. So, here, you want to do it? Read it.
No.
In a British accent. All right. It was a lovely way to go, her son said. I can imagine the smile on her face when she looked at her cards and she knew she had a winning hand. She died doing what she loved to do. So, there you go.
There was just a little funny story at work. Some woman came in and she said, caught. So, I turned around and I said, caught. I thought that was her last name. She wanted a cat license. And I repeated it the same exact way that she said it. Caught. Yeah, that wasn't... She laughed, thank God. I wasn't really making fun of her.
So, yeah, see, we're running out of time. We got way...
We have way too much
We're
to
way
say.
Over here. This is going
to
be way too long of a show for you to watch. I'm going to have to edit stuff out here.
Please.
So, yeah, so that's it, man. Our time is way up.
Really?
Yeah, look at the time. It's 37 minutes here.
Wow, that's
I'm going to have to edit... I tell you, yeah, I'm going to have to
time
move this to an
us,
hour
Dennis.
Show, you know?
I'll never watch it.
Yeah, how are you going to be a guest if you don't watch the show? You watch the show. It's the funniest show on
Christmas
TV.
I watched show.
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
I was a little...
Are you going to watch this one at least?
I am. I was a little upset to learn how much you loved Christmas music. We've spent how many Christmas Eves together, and I did not understand your love of Christmas music.
You're getting out of the picture. Look at that.
I didn't know that.
Really?
Because I love Christmas music as well.
Oh, so I'll have to kind of have to come back for the Christmas. That's right. You must have been screwed your entire life.
Never.
Really?
Not until I got married.
Yeah, but being born on Christmas and sharing your birthday with Jesus.
Well, I used to, when the kids were little, I would tell them I was Jesus Christ, and they really believed it. But I don't know. People love their birthday. That I don't get. Because to me, it was Christmas. It wasn't really a big deal. And usually at 6 o'clock at night, everyone would be like, oh, yeah, happy birthday. Every year, they would forget it.
Oh, by the way.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, so.
Good thing I'm not so sensitive.
Yeah, right. So, well, bring up your cup. Thanks for coming on.
Where's that Home Sweet Home?
We're going to play it. What do you mean? It's not on this album.
Oh.
Home Sweet Home's not on this album, but that's the one we're going to perform. But I'll have to say, here I go, letting go of another hang-up, Sharon.
Letting go.
That's it. That Motley Crue. Put that one down. That one's not good.
Yeah, you can hold girls, this girls, girls, girls.
Yeah, that girls, girls, girls is good. But this is their best album. This right after they got a rehab, they recorded this. So they were all fresh and ready to go. And this was their last good album. And I recommend this album. It was a little pricey, but I definitely am happy I own this now. I'm going to start listening. I'm going to go back. I'm going to buy a Winger album, a Striper. I'm going to be all heavy metal stuff now.
Striper's so, Christian rock. Yeah, let's get them.
Yeah, but I would
they weren't cool.
No, no, no. Either was Winger.
Skid Row?
I didn't like any of that. But like I said, I'm going to start all over now and start out new.
Europe?
Pretend I was a 12-year-old girl and start liking it. But anyway, that's it for the show. You can put that down now. I recommend this. It's very good. It's not one of the best albums ever recorded, but it's very good.
Vince Neil, by the way, he did, when he was all clean, his vice then became women.
Well, there
and,
you go.
But then he did start drinking again. Women tend to do that to men, I think. Eventually.
Yeah,
you all start drinking.
A whole nother show. Yep, so definitely going to have
really
you back.
We could really branch this show out.
Yeah, definitely. So...
All right,
thanks for coming on. Stay tuned
live
for
from
all
Dennis's
the
house.
Music numbers live from Dennis's house. See you next Sunday.
Thanks for watching.
Here we are. Take one. Home Sweet Home by Motley Crue by Alan and Dennis.
I see.